Hey everybody, it's Traci from Downward Dog Rising. I'm going to give you a spinal mobility sequence tonight with hip opener. So we're going to do yin, a slow-paced workout, but it's going to go deep into your muscle fascia because we want to go deep to bypass the muscles for lasting structural change. So join me and let's begin. I'm going to have you start off. Sit in Sukhasana, easy pose. And we're just gonna focus inward for a second and set our intention for this workout. Ground, center, focus in, just to be the best that you can be in this present moment. Take a deep inhale. We're going to start off in a seated position, and I just want to give you a little hip opener. We're going to take our feet, soles of feet come together. We're going to do a little baddha konasana, butterfly stretch. I want you to gently allow your thigh bones to twist externally into your hip sockets. There's space between your heels and your groin, so no need to have your legs come too close. Root down into the bottom of your pelvis, lengthen up to top of head. Maybe you'll grab your feet. Maybe you'll have hands on mat in front of you, whatever feels good to you. Imagine a thick liquid. Your knees are floating in a thick liquid, giving your hip joints support. Stay here and breathe. Going inward. Notice anything that your body's telling you. In your joints, your muscles, subtle energy bodies in and around your body. Going inward. Feel the air as it enters your nostrils, as it touches the back of your throat, as it goes down your windpipe into your lungs. Feel the chest expand. Feel that ribs open wide. Sink down into the bottom of your pelvis. Lengthen all the way up the spine to the top of your head. Firm foundation to sit on. Gently lengthen to top of head as you inhale. Slowly exhale as you hip hinge forward. Going a little deeper, go to your edge. We're not in competition with anyone else. We're merely trying to do our best to hit our bodies in a way that is beneficial to us, to create openness and expansiveness, heart, body, mind, to receive new information and to be open. One more deep inhale. Slowly you're gonna come up, take the knees, draw them towards each other. Take hands by sides, gently do a little windshield wiper from side to side here. Return center. We're gonna do 10 bridges. This is going to help your low lumbar spine be stable. Careful not to have your heels come too close to buttocks. You're going to walk them out a little bit. Shoulders straight above your hips. Your arms reach long. Lengthen fingertips away from shoulders. Arms, palms pressed firm into mat. Scoop in from pubic bone. Zip up to navel. Keep length and low back. Bridge pelvis into air. Stretch tailbone long. Exhale, scoop abdominals to back. Lower pelvis to mat. Inhale, lengthen your spine. Exhale, scoop and lift. Energy past the knees. Inhale, down. Exhale, scoop and lift. Collarbones wide. Blades wide across upper middle back. 7, 6, scoop core tight to back. 5, tailbone long away from breastbone. 4, 3 more. Openness across front of chest and shoulders. 2 more. Hips simultaneously. Last one. Take both hands, interclasp your fingers together. Drop those shoulders further down and back away from ears. Sides of neck are long. Engage gluteals. Core is strong. Drawing into back. Press hips to sky. Stay here and breathe. We're going to do 5 deep inhales here. Really expand into each side of your ribs, getting into the lower lobes of your lungs. Knees in line with hip sockets. Two more deep inhales. One more inhale to the middle of your low back. Softly let it go. Unclasp hands, palms press into mat, and lower pelvis down into the mat. Tailbone heavy, head lengthens away from tailbone. Reach under knees, gently draw knees into chest. Deep inhale to center of back between your two shoulder blades, mid-back, thoracic spine. One more deep inhale here. Gently lower down. Turn to one side. Stack your knees and your ankles. Take your hand to your top hip. Pull your hip away from your rib cage. Create some length. Press up with top arm. Bring your elbow directly in line under shoulder. Careful not to collapse. Create length and space on each side of body. Open up side lines. Ankles are stacked. Knees are stacked. Sides of body, waist elongate. You're gonna think of a sling. Activating your obliques, wrapping from under those ribs, chest is open wide, hand to hip, and just stay here. Activate those obliques, sides of waist long, and breathe. Really lift your bottom rib cage up. Your bottom hip is lifted, shoulders in alignment. Breathing in, feel ribs expand. And hold, spine is long. One more time for deep inhale. Gently lower down. Swing knees to other side of body. Plant your elbow directly under your shoulder. Create length on each side of your rib cage. Collarbones open wide. You're gonna do a little modified side plank. Lift up, this will prepare. Get those obliques to wrap. Breathing in, breathing out. Really lift those obliques, hip lifts up. And stay here. Create length on each side of your waistline. Sides and neck remain long. Breathing into all sides of ribs. Front, back, and sides. Feel length in spine. Two more deep inhales. And last deep inhale. Gently lower down. Come up to a seated position. We're gonna go into half a butterfly. Draw your right knee in. The sole bottom of your foot is going to reach towards left groin. Float your arms up. Knee to sky, leg is active. Back of thigh actively presses into your mat. Inhale, lengthen up. Stretch spine tall on your inhalation. Align the center of your sternum, your breastbone, over the center of your thigh. And we're gonna gently hip hinge over to your maximal point of length from head to tailbone. Maybe grab your shin, your ankle, or your foot. Gently pull, knee to sky, and stay here. Go to your edge, go as far as you can. We're gonna hold here. When we hold poses for longer, we actually will produce hyaluronic acid in our bodies, which is very beneficial for long-lasting changes because it bypasses just the muscles and it goes into our connective webbing and our fibers really deep. Into our fascia of the joints. Go deeper as you feel release. Inhale, lengthen spine. And soften. Be open to receive. Take another deep inhale into the center of your low back. Softly release into it. Gently start to walk hands in. Lengthen to top of head. Gently are going to extend other side. Half butterfly, other leg. Draw the bottom of your foot into your groin. Shoulders straight over hips. Bring your sternum, your breastbone directly in line over the center of your femur bone, your thigh. Lengthen arms to sky, stretching upwards. Equal weight through each half of your pelvis. Hip hinge, elongate, inhale, spine elongates, exhale, hinge from hips. If you need a little support, hands can go under the knee. You could be sitting on a folded yoga blanket if you want a little extra lumbar back support. Walk to shin, walk hands to ankle, maybe to foot. You're gonna start going inward, find your edge, go as far as you possibly can without force. Now really stretch your sternum, your breastbone long. Elongate through center of spine, thoracic spine, and breathe. Yield, give in. It's all about balance between yin and yang energy, masculine and feminine energies. We need them to be in balance, ideally, for optimal functionality in our life. Perfect complement to one another. One cannot exist unless the other one is existing. One cannot be without the other. Masculine is action. Yin is receptivity, passivity. But there's also strength in passivity and receptivity at the right moment. You feel a give, go a little deeper. Keep spine long, mid-back, thoracic spine. Pull breastbone forward and through. Deep inhale, one more deep inhale to center of low back. And gently walk hands in, coming all the way up. We're gonna go into our caterpillar next. We're gonna extend the legs out. Maybe shake out your knees. Inhale, arms to sky, open shoulders, chest, slight little extension. Breathing in and exhale. One more time, breathing in and exhale. We're going to engage, feel front of thighs lift off knees, feel the backs of those thighs pressing down into the mat, sink down into this bottom of your sits bones. Inhale, reach arms overhead, you lengthen your spine. Every time you inhale, lengthen up. Again, if you want extra back support, sit on folded yoga blankets. You could sit on a cushion even. Really feel the back of those ribs expand, chest is open, collarbones open, sternum lifts up. Reach towards lateral pinky toe sides of feet. Feel the energy up the inner thighs. Rotate outward. Lengthen. Find your edge. Go to the point where you can't take it any further and stay here. Be the observer of your thoughts, of your emotions, whatever comes up. No judgment, just be the watcher, the observer, and go deeper. Feel a give, go deeper, keep going inward, being the observer, be the witness, emotions, thoughts, whatever comes up. Think of a lake, tranquil, stillness, coolness of the water. See your reflection. See inside. Go deeper. One more deep inhale. Slowly start to walk hands in. Lengthen top of head away from tailbone. We're going to take it down to our mat. We're going to lie down on our abdominals. We're going to take it into Sphinx next. Sphinx, Sphinx. I think of the pyramids of Egypt. Sphinx. We're gonna lie down. Place the tops of your feet down on the mat. Hip points are firm down on the mat. Think of pubic bone firm on mat. Create length by lengthening from pubic bone all the way up to your sternum, your breastbone. And then what I want you to do here, take a second, lie flat on the mat, forehead on mat, spread fingers wide. Press your palms firmly down into your mat. Feel width across upper mid back, shoulder blades widen. Breathe in, settle into the pelvis, hips sink deeper into mat, pubic bone sinks deeper into mat. Elongate up to breastbone sternum. Slowly walk elbows in. Bring elbows directly under your shoulders. Soften the neck. Relax shoulders out of ears. Palms press into the floor. Pressing palms against the floor. Feel the bottom tips of those shoulder blades widen across the back. Feel the front of your collarbones opening across the front. The abdominals dome through the body into the front of your spine. Reach inside the body into the front of your spine. And let's open the front of your spine. Giving you energy. In a passive way, we can still create energy passively. Gently tilt right ear towards right shoulder as you stretch the left side of your neck. If you want to deepen the stretch, lift left foot, rotate left leg and hip slightly over. If it tenses your neck or shoulders, keep legs centered. Feel a deep stretch across low back. Right ear towards right shoulder, shoulders away from ears. Deep inhale, gently return. Palms press into mat, lengthen from pubic bone to breastbone. Tilt left ear towards left shoulder. You can stay here if you like. If you want to deepen the stretch, bend left knee, slowly lengthen, reach left leg behind you, keep left ear tilting towards left shoulder, making sure shoulders avoid compressing, back, low back avoids compressing, really get a stretch across the side back, through the hip. One more deep inhale. Return center. Extend leg. With your hands where they are, if you want to lessen the stretch and not go too high into low back, we're gonna go into seal. Maybe stretch hands a little further out. Extend arms, elbows point down towards mat. Tilt chin a tiny little bit towards front of neck. Stretch back of neck long. Soften your jaw, your facial muscles. Feel the tongue at the top of the mouth. Feel the throat even lengthen. Feel the energy as it travels up and down your spine, the subtle energies. Abdominals dome into the front of the spine. Lengthen through low back. Feel a vibration of energies, the base of your spine. One more deep inhale here. Slowly you're gonna lower down to the mat. Relax your forehead on the backs of your hands. Gently wiggle pelvis, hips side to side. Let your pelvis, hips sink, settle into your mat. Feel grounded and centered into the earth. And you are supported. Slowly take hands under your shoulders. Shoulders back away from ears. Press up onto hands and knees. Go back into rest pose. You could have tops of feet rest on mat. If you need extra support for knee joints, you can curl toes under so some of the force is redirected from here back down into your feet. Not as much pressure. Sink your hips back over your heels. Your sits bones pull back towards the mat behind you. Your breastbone pulls forward and through the arms. Reach through fingertips. Forehead on mat, maybe forehead is on a rolled up towel or a folded yoga blanket. Stretch from armpits to the fingertips. Sink into the back of those sits bones, let them sink, pull behind you, opening up the tissue in the low back, pulling apart. If it's more comfortable for you, shoulders draw away from ears, palms reach to sky, collarbones wide in front, shoulders down and back. You can relax arms by sides of body, palms reaching upwards. Do what feels appropriate in this present moment. One more deep inhale here. Slowly walk your hands in. Gently press up to hands and knees. Walk your feet forward and through. We're gonna do half Lord of the Fishes. Ardha, Matsi. And Drasana, what I want you to do, you're going to take your right foot, fold the right leg in underneath you, then you're going to take the left leg. What I want you to do, plant the bottom of your left foot firmly down on your mat. Bottom of the left foot firmly planted down on your mat. What I want you to do next, think of rooting each sits bone straight down against the mat. Center your body. Then what I want you to do here, your arms rise up, lengthen your spine. I want you to rotate. You're gonna reach fingertips behind you, palm against the mat. You're gonna rotate towards this other leg here. What I want you to do here, you're gonna extend. I want you to gently think of this right inner thigh. The right inner thigh is drawing in towards your groin, the opposite side. I want you to feel your belly muscles drawing in deeper. And we're twisting, we're rotating. Feel that inner left inner groin, abdominal belly muscles pulling deeper into your spine. Now what I want you to do, rise up to top of head, push down into the bottom of this back hand, and I want you to gently do a tiny little arch through the center of your thoracic spine. It's like you're doing a small little back bend to get a little deeper, more length in spine, and this will help you breathe better. If you ever feel like you get caught and it's hard to breathe from middle back, lift your breastbone up. Gently keep pressing against that leg. Push into that back hand. Feel those blades wide across your back, your chest lifts. This is great for insomnia or mild depression. Avoid if you have herniated discs or back injury. Press into that back hand, little tiny arch. Use those core muscles, drawing deeper. Deep inhale, deep exhale, and gently release. Good job. It's cold in here tonight. Shake out knees. Chin drops down. Neck roll to one shoulder. Chin drops down. Neck roll to opposite shoulder. Come back center. Switching sides. Draw the left leg in. That left knee bends in. Root down into the bottom of your pelvis. Take this right leg. Cross over the left knee. Firmly root. Press down into the bottom of that right foot. Feel each half of pelvis rooting down into the earth, into your mat. And I want you to start to feel your abdominals, your belly scoops in, your abdominals pull deeply inward, supporting your spine. You're gonna feel that inner thigh draw into your belly even. Arms lift up into air, lengthen up to top of head, rotate. Hand comes down, pull that knee a little closer. Drop this hand behind you, press firmly into the mat behind you. Keep lengthening upwards. Feel your abdominal wall scooping in deeper to your spine. Inner thigh comes closer to your abdominals. Press into that back hand and lift chest to sky. Little back bend and breathe. Feel like you can catch your breath easier in the center of your back. Heart center, opening. Space, thoracic spine, releasing. Press into that back palm as you lengthen to top of head. Pull inner thigh towards groin, opposite leg. Deep inhale. One more time. Expansiveness into your ribs. Breathing in. Now, one more deep inhale. Gently untwist spine. Undo ankle. Extend both legs long. What I want you to do here, we're going to come all the way down into our Shavasana. Take hands under your knees. Press feet into mat. Feel core draw into the length of your spine and roll down gently to your mat. Lengthening all the way as you go. Come down into your Shavasana. Palms reach to the sky. Legs can sway outward. Tailbone is heavy on your mat. Feel the two shoulder blades. Feel the scapula, the edges of them. Pull down and out as they widen into the mat underneath you. And as the edge of each one of the scapula draw down and out, feel the bones of the collarbones spread wide across chest and shoulders in front and just melt into the mat. Feel the tongue hit the roof of your mouth and the back of your throat open, the neck lengthen. Feel the base of the skull. If you want, take your thumbs under your earlobes. Take hands under back of head and just gently from under your earlobes, lengthen. Just stretch the back of the neck a little longer, as if the top of the head is lengthening away from the neck. And then gently release, bringing arms down by sides. And just stay here. Just settle into the benefits that our practice tonight gave us for today. Lengthen spine. Easier to breathe deeper. Making us feel lighter, more at peace. See the reflection on the calm, still waters of a tranquil lake. Being the observer, no judgment. As the breath goes deeper, cortisol levels in your body decrease, calming, giving us a very calming effect. Our breath slows down, becomes more full and efficient. And that's the power of passivity. knowing when to act and knowing when to yield. Slowly bring your awareness back to your body, leaving the tranquil waters of that lake looking like a mirror shining back at you. It is there anytime you need to reflect. Slowly start to wiggle your toes. Slowly start to wiggle your fingers. Stretch your arms overhead. Elongate. Deep inhale, deep exhale. Preferably, you're going to turn onto your right side, folding knees in. I'm going to turn to my left because I'm facing you. Slowly turn onto your side. Give your body a moment to adjust. Our blood pressure is different when we lie down, when we sit, and when we stand. Orthostatic hypotension is if you jump up from a reclined position and you see stars or feel like you're going to black out. Slowly press into that top hand. Come up into a seated position so we can end our practice together. Sukhasana, easy pose. I hope this session has restored some balance and peace to you. We did something spinal mobility. It can translate into anything else in your life, giving you support, making you not feel tight or imbalanced. Firm foundation. Bring palms together, heart center. And Anjali Mudra. Thank you for sharing your time with me. Appreciate you all, everyone. Peace. Take care. See you soon. Bye. Metta blessings, loving kindness. Bye.